that he fled from his brothers. The word of the living God, don't miss this. And the worthless men banded together with Jephthah. Don't miss it. And went out raiding with him. Oh, I don't want you. This is so pretty. I don't want you to miss what I'm getting ready to show you in this text. Because it said that a bunch of worthless men banded together with this reject. Please don't miss what I'm telling you. The NIV version does not call them worthless. The NIV version calls them scoundrels. The NLT version calls them worthless rebels. The NASB version calls them worthless fellows. The King James version calls them vain men. All I'm trying to tell you is that the people he got hooked up were no good people. But don't mess it. Don't miss it. They were no good people. But at least they were better than the people who rejected him. They were no good people. But at least there were people who had not only his back, but they also had his heart. God help me. Church folk don't know when to shout to you. Because every now and again, you can't be looking for good people dressed up in a suit and a tie. You can't be looking for good people just because they got a good job. You can't be looking for people just because they got a fat bank account. But every now and again, God will allow you to hook up with some scoundrels, some worthless, vain individuals who don't know all that about God, but at least they got your back. Is there anybody in this house? Preacher, I know that's right, because as of today, I got some homeboys still in Florida. They ain't got on no suit, they ain't on Wall Street, but they got on jeans and a hoodie, with their hat turned backwards, with dreadlocks in their hair, with gold teeth in their mouth, and whether you know it or not, they still got my back. And though I got about 10 people in here, who can say, preacher, some of my best friends, they ain't all that good, they ain't all that perfect, but one thing I know for sure is that they